another Don's with Dad video. Today we are working on our Corvette.
Recently our speedometer has quit working, so we think we have narrowed it down to the cruise control transducer.
All right, so I know Bill just mentioned that we were talking about replacing our transducer, and that is this piece right here. It's kind of tough to see, my hands are really big, but you can see that there's two speedometer cables here coming in, one in the bottom, one in the top. I've already disconnected the one on the top. And if I take that cable and I grab the end of it, and Jackson, will you take this and face it towards the speedometer? There we go. I take this cable and I spin it. You should see that speedometer move.
Yep.
Correct? So that tells us that at least our cable and our speedometer are working. And my thoughts are is that it is this transducer. So the transducer we got came from Advanced Auto. I'll go ahead and show you what we're working with today. And the I'll leave the part description down in the comment section so you know what we got. But here's our brand new one. And essentially it sits in here just like this, up underneath that master cylinder. And a couple vacuum lines. Make sure you put your vacuum lines in the order that they go. I've read a couple of funny posts through some of the forums where they put those on backwards, and when they set the cruise, the car accelerated. Definitely don't want to be that guy. But seems pretty straightforward. The big issue is it's just really tight right there. So we're going to go ahead and we'll go ahead and try to knock this thing out.
So you're getting ready to take the cables off, and Dad realized that the bottom cable was loose. So he tightened it, and then this is what happened. Hooray! With the speedometer fix, our last thing for getting this car ready for the road is the water pump.
Yeah, when we got the car, I noticed it was making an odd noise up into the kind of in the belt area, the belt assemblies. And if I shake this water pump, you can see there's a lot of play in it. So shouldn't be doing that. So we'll get that replaced here in the next week. Surprisingly enough, it's not leaking coolant, which is kind of crazy. I thought it would be pouring coolant out everywhere, but that is the last thing that we've got to get this car ready to enjoy on the road. But you know, we've posted some pictures of it and some videos, and we really haven't talked much about it or told you what it was. So it's a 1982 Corvette. First year of the Crossfire injection. It's silver over claret, which is kind of a cool, almost looks black, but it's burgundy with the red pinstripe. And the car has 58,000 miles, a two-owner car, and kind of cool. It's got a cloth interior. Bill's made himself at home in here. But everything's original in the car outside of a cassette player that was added. So I'm going to try to look and see if we can find an original Corvette radio for it. But everything works all the way down to the power seats, the power locks, headlights. I just did the vacuum rebuild boots on that, so that's good to go. I fixed the door handle where these things always get where they're tough to open from the driver's side, but we're good to go there. But yeah, what a beautiful car, and what a just a great survivor, I guess is the best way of putting it. And from the body side of it, the car looks fantastic outside of a little bump up here in the nose, which we're going to see what a body shop can do for us and just fix these little imperfections up here. These big long noses, they're pretty easy to bump when you're not paying attention. But yeah, once again,
very small in the car.
But once again, thanks for watching. I don't know if we'll do the water pump just based on the time with everything we've got going on. I may have that done somewhere else, but either way, look forward to many more videos of this car as we take it around. Hopefully we get to see you out and about at car shows and parades and cars and coffees and whatever. But we really haven't had much to talk about over the last little bit, just based with COVID and everything going on. But you will notice that where this car is where the laser used to be. And the laser is gone. We decided to go ahead and part ways with that car. And it's found a great new owner that we're excited to keep in partnership with and hopefully see that car get built and back on the road one day. But this is obviously where the Corvette is. And the old 3100 is still with us. It's actually out in our new garage. And we've got a lot of fun things going on. So this was the K cart. The shopping cart didn't fit, but we put a little Harbor Freight Predator engine in it. I think Bill's probably put 50,000 miles on that thing in the last couple months. We also got a Sea-Doo XP 787, sealed XP 800 that we'll be working on. We got the mini bike, and I think that's it for right now.
How about the four-wheeler?
Oh, yeah, we got a four-wheeler, too. So we've got a lot of things to work on, but two running and driving cars to take with Cars and Coffees to car shows and enjoy working on. So I know Bill's been pretty excited about this car. He's not a big fan of Corvettes, though. So thanks again for watching. Look forward to many videos. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button. Make sure you sign up for notifications so that way you can see all the new stuff coming out. But 2021 is going to be a fun year. We got some fun stuff to take out, and you know, this is a channel designed to promote spending time with the youth, enjoying time with the kiddos, teaching them something fun, and just having time away from work, electronics, the world as crazy as it is right now. So we look forward to meeting up with you and your stories and your own donuts with dad, you know, donuts with mom, whatever it may be, stories and projects that you have. So reach out to us, let us know what you're working on, and we will see you later.
Just say for a seatbelt.